I'm always really interested in things that cut against the grain. So like taking lasers out of the club and putting them with an orchestra is to me a fascinating thing.
Going through piece by piece. We're probably not going to be running a whole lot. I want you all to get used to the lights, get used to the lasers.
For me, the traditional Swan Lake, it's perfect, but we are recontextualizing a classic in a way that's going to keep it relevant. One of the things that excites me about working with the visual arts community is that they don't have a lot of experience working with the performing arts. They don't have the same expectations or the same limitations. Once I realized what the context was going to be, one thing led to another and Tiffany Woodard came on board.
That is what it sounds like. Is that what you want to write? I make the kids the very coolest Halloween costumes. That's like kind of my thing. I also make Halloween costumes for other people. And I don't like saying that I'm self-taught because my mom taught me, but I think that I always frustrated her because I hated following a pattern because it was really confusing, just the way my brain works. Here's the difference between what I generally do and with the ballet. Generally, I'll come up with the inspiration and then I'll just dive right into it. But with this, I made these sketches, I turned them in, and then the ladies in the costume shop like magically just made it all happen. If I were making it for just a costume, there's lots of things that you would sew, but then there's also lots of things that you would glue. I mean, I've stapled in the past, but you can't staple a ballet costume. There's no way. They don't use glue. That was made very clear to me. They do not use glue at all.
But you're wanting to kind of emulate a neck, like a swan neck.
And like a beak.
But this part?
This would be the head.
Okay, so it's okay if that's a little bit wider.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then I can put some googly eyes on here too.
It's been a little bit intimidating to kind of have to like rise to like a very professional level because the ballet costume shop is legit.
You know, another thing with Swan Lake, you know, you're dealing with the white swan, the black swan, and I think something Robert was attracted to when he saw some of our laser shows was this idea of light and the absence of light. It's essentially abstract animation. It's like creating slowly evolving sets instead of like a traditional laser show.
It is a ballet still.
Yeah, very much a classical ballet, just lasers.
For a really long time, since the 60s, laser light, laser technology, really has been a symbol of the future, a symbol of science fiction. And the way that the movement of the lasers is an extension of the movement of the dancers was astounding to me. They represent the story by allowing us to create a whole character without a person. You know, Rothbart's entire character, that evil force, even if it's not called Rothbart, is all done with light. I just know that the people who I'm working with have so much respect for this story and they don't want to compromise the audience's experience. All they want to do is enhance it.
Robert is very intentional about putting people together who are going to like mutually stretch each other. And so, you know, at times it's painful, but you get something really beautiful in the end.
Swan and pieces.
Swan and pieces.
Head pieces.
Oh yeah, they look good.
They look really good.
They look like punk rock swans.
Ryan is such a huge champion of mine. He convinced Robert that Robert needed to hire me, that Robert just could not possibly live without me. Having two people in the same household who are working on the same project, it's been really intense. Right now, Ryan and I are like ships in the night. We're lucky if we get to see each other. I think Ryan and Garrett are working really long hours. He's like a machine. He doesn't stop. I don't know how he does it. I take like 4 naps a day. But I'm also pregnant, so I have an excuse.
My number one priority as a leader in the arts is to create the profound belief that ballet is a contemporary art form. No other dance form can do what ballet dancers can do. They don't need to use words, they can express a story through their bodies. And so when I take on a production like Swan Lake, respecting that tradition, pushing that tradition, using that tradition and sharing that tradition with this community and beyond lends itself to a wonderful experience for an audience member on the night.